Brush smoothing is another brilliant new feature and attribute we can assign to our brushes now in Photoshop CC 2018. In this video, I'm going to show you why it is so important and how to utilize all its features. First of all, when you select a brush, you can find the option up here called smoothing. Now, I reduced this down to 0% for now, just as a demonstration, but every brush by default is now set to 10% smoothing. It's good to know that it's already there by default. But by setting it to 0%, let me show you how it looks when I draw with the mouse, first of all. So if I start drawing lines with this brush, that's how it looks with the mouse. Now I'm going to draw with the tablet, something similar. So I'm using a Wacom tablet, and obviously I can do much better with that. But now using the tablet still, but with an increased smoothing value, maybe set to around 60%, let's see what I can do. I can do much neater work doing these curves, and I can really control whether I want smaller or bigger and really plan ahead how I want to do my twists and turns. So the best way I can describe this feature is that it's almost like a steady hand drawing technique, where as if you're holding the pencil with two hands, or maybe someone is guiding your hand is probably a better metaphor for it. Because what is happening when you have smoothing turned on is that your actual brush is slightly behind drawing, so it's delayed a bit, and it's almost like you are pulling the brush around. Now you might think that that is not a good thing, but actually for this to make it work well, this delay really helps. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to set the percent back to zero, and I'm going to just draw a line here. So it's a drawing I've done recently of Geralt from the Witcher series, and let's say I want to add the contouring nicely. So that's like a rough sketch. I need to tidy this up. So I'm going to go around it and draw the lines. Now I'm not using any smoothing now, and you can see that I'm doing quite a good job here, but I get loads of little inaccuracies along the way. Now if I increase the smoothing up to, let's say, 100%, and then I start drawing, notice how my line is actually delayed behind the cursor, but then I can get to every detail and just really neatly refine them. So if I zoom a little bit closer, you might see actually even better what I mean. So I have really good control over which details I want to emphasize and which details I just would like to keep nice and steady and smooth like that. And of course, if I reduce my brush size, I can get in the inner parts as well and draw over these details once again with that nice same precision. Maybe that's a little bit too thin, so I'm going to just increase my brush size slightly and just show you that this is when I draw with smoothing. And I'm going to again turn off smoothing and try to draw this again. You can see that even though I'm using the tablet, I will always have these bumps where I don't want them to show up. So in the past, what I would have normally done is to use the rotate tool, press R and keep holding it to rotate on the keyboard, and then it switches back to the brush tool. So you notice if I turn the whole canvas around, it actually helps me to draw better because I'm right-handed. This is a more comfortable direction for me to draw. But I'm just going to press escape and demonstrate that even in an uncomfortable angle, with the smoothing on, I can refine this line and override what was the original line. Or if I want to, I can follow the original line much closer than without smoothing. Once again, let's see this line here. So the original wobbly line is now replaced with a much neater and more steady line. Same thing goes here. I can nicely curve this line around there, and so on and so forth. So you can imagine using this feature can really help for a lot of different things in Photoshop. So for decoration, for contouring, And of course, it doesn't stop that because we have additional options. So it's not just the tolerance value that you can change, but you have additional smoothing options like the pulled string mode, which is quite cool. If I turn the smoothing down a bit, maybe around 10%, and I turn that option on, I can show you what difference that makes. So with that being on, I'm going to get this radius, and the drawing only starts where my cursor gets out of this radius. The radius will be bigger when you increase the smoothing value. So the lower the smoothing value, the smaller this circle will be, the diameter of this circle. And you can see again, that's a slightly different way of drawing once again. So it's not exactly the same as the previous option I showed you. But again, it can help to really draw with accurate lines. Sometimes it might get in the way. So like here, when I wanted to do a more fast turn, it's probably a little bit easier to draw without the pull string mode. But once again, to draw a more complex line here, instead of using a low smooth value, going up in the smoothing value will help me to do this with one go and still get a really nice result like that. Now, if you don't like seeing that magenta line that appears when I'm drawing, you can go to the preferences, and under the cursors, you have this new option, the show brush leash while smoothing, and you can even change its color if you want to. So that is the new brush smoothing control in Photoshop CC 2018. Make sure you give it a try whenever you work with brush-based tools.